Thank you. Thank you for the introduction. Climate change is happening. We hear every day about it. We can read about it in magazines, which show us potential implications. And we need to act. We need to do something now, immediately. And if you look at this picture which is shown behind me, you see things which we have to avoid, where we have to do something against it. But something is wrong in this picture if you look at it. It's not the potential risk which is shown. It's the date at which this picture has been published. 1986, more than 35 years ago, the climate change risks were announced. Something is wrong. Why did not any things not happen since then? But that's not true. Things have happened. Science at the time became active. Investigate the subject, reason for it, and counter actions. For example, in Europe today, 1/3 of the greenhouse gas emissions are coming out of the building sector. And we know the solutions against it. We have to do better insulation, and we have to find better heating technology using renewable energies. Politics, so society, became aware of the subject and created activities. Parties were created, like the Greens. Other parties took on the program, and they are now working on legislation. And the young generation at the time became aware of it and made it an initiative. I personally, at the time, decided to dedicate my engineering life to the topic and to work on building technology, efficient heating systems, and renewable energies. But what about the technology? Where are we standing? As the company Bosch, where we have our slogan, invented for life. The heat pump is the technology which is best fitted to heat our houses. And the first heat pump which Bosch Junkers introduced was already in 1978. At the time it worked, it was difficult to install, but it worked quite a long time. Today it looks different. Today we have a full product range, we established technology, we know how to install it. We know that especially in new buildings, but as well renovated buildings, this is a very good technology which fits to the use case. But there are situations in which a pure heat pump is not the best solution. If you go in a very old building, which is not yet renovated, then the heat pump is not perfectly fitting. In these old buildings, the best would be to just install again a boiler, since the boiler is fitting to the heating system, fitting to assuring the comfort, the people trust in it. So, but this is not possible anymore, since if you look at the products of today, they do burn gas, and we are not allowed anymore to burn gas. So why not combine the both products? Combining the heat pump with the boiler. And that's exactly what the hybrid heat pump is about. And now I want to show you a graph. Sorry, it's a bit complicated, but I think it's worth looking at this graph and trying to understand. Here you see on the screen the operation hours of a heating system over the year. And you can see here the white bars are accounting for the amount of hours per year, that the highest amount of hours is between 0 degrees and 10 degrees. And this is according to our experience. This is typically when it's getting cold, you are happy to come home, and the heating is on. And only very few hours are really at the time when it's really, really cold, minus 10, minus 15. It's not happening that often, but at that time, you really want to have a real strong heating power coming to your house. And that's exactly how heating systems are designed. They operate with the highest power and the highest temperature at the lowest temperatures. That means the real strong power is only needed at very, very cold temperatures. And on that chart, you can then see how the hybrid heat pump is working. The heat pump is working at most of the time when the demand on the heating system is not that high. And then the boiler is only jumping in at the time when it's really, really cold. And the combination of these both makes a hybrid heat pump. Now you may say, perfect, sounds easy. Where's the product? And I have to tell you, we introduced it already in 2011. You can see how it looks like. I have to admit, we introduced it, and the product failed in the market. It was too complex to understand, too difficult to install, and too expensive. We had to take it some years later back from the market. The idea failed. And now, you can imagine management's delight when, in 2017, I turned around. We need to make a project to develop a hybrid heat pump. At the time, I was in charge of the development of floor standing boilers, gas and oil. And main task was to consolidate the business and to generate the money which was needed to develop the heat pump developments, which were done somewhere else in a different product area. But working on this product, my team and myself, we saw this use case, the buildings, the old buildings in which these boilers are installed. We do need a very dedicated solution fitting to that type of use case. Then we said, OK, let's investigate, let's brainstorm, let's find an idea. And we found a new approach how to we can do this hybrid heat pumps. And this idea I then presented to the management and told them, listen, I know it failed some years ago, but we have a very good idea and we believe in it. Please allow us to run the project. Give us the money to do it. And they looked at us and said, failed some years ago, you want to do it again? OK, let's do it. And the money we spend on you, we'll take it as a kind of insurance policy. So we don't know exactly what's coming, but OK, for that money, make the project. So we started, we did it, we ran the project in 2017. And 3 years later, the product was ready. And we had even then the possibility to go in a research project and to take a very, very old building. You can see it on the screen, which before installation of the hybrid solution was having a 40 kilowatt boilers and consuming 4 or 5 times more than a new building of such a size. And then after installing our hybrid heat pump solution, immediately we could show that we can reduce the gas consumption directly by 80% on the heating side without having an impact on the comfort. So it is possible. You can do immediately in such an old building a gas-saving activity. And then the year after, the building got renovated. Then we could, the heat consumption was totally reduced then by more than 60% with a now isolated building. And the heat pump, the hybrid heat pump, which was working inside, was working nicely. And we could even then increase the heat pump share in the hybrid system. So what we saw, this solution is really a no-regret solution. You really can install it, and it fits whatever we later you do in the building. After that good experience, we then decided to convert the whole product range, which we are now selling in the German market, to that solution. And we are now ready for the legislation, which is coming up next year, since this is exactly what the legislation is prescribing. You need to have at 2/3, 65% of renewables, and this is what all our German products now can offer to our customers. And I can tell you already, we are doing similar things for all the other countries which are coming up in the next years. So, very nice story, but what can we learn out of it? Well, first, if you combine use case experience with new technology and bring them together in a team, you really can generate new, innovative, and successful products. And on a more general sense, as time comes by, it's worth reconsidering failed ideas. If time is fitting, you learned from the past mistakes, and you have the right team supporting the idea. A failed idea worth reconsidering and taking on again. Thank you.